Okay, so the next topic we are going to discuss is about functions. Like, functions will help us to write a code, or we can put the reusable code, and we can put the reusable code inside a method in Java, and similarly we can put a reusable code in functions in Java. And also, suppose if you perform some validations, we can make use of the function for the referencing as well as for validating, like that. So we can create a functions in JavaScript like that. For example, so I will just delete this old one. So we can create a functions in JavaScript just like this. For example, function followed by function name. For example, we can give a display as the function. So, and we can write a logic into it, document.writeln displaying function. Then we can call this function with help of the function name, like display of. Just like that. So we can create a function with a syntax function followed by function name and the logic, internal logic. Then we can directly call this function. So there are two types of function: function without return type and function with return type. And this function is said to be function without return type because there is no return keyword into it. So we can just call this function. Maybe we'll just check this. So if I refresh, you'll get displaying function. Then after that, refresh the page to execute the JavaScript again, like that. So this is how we can create a function. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a return type function. For example, say add, which will add two numbers, maybe A as well as B. So A comma B, like that. So instead of printing, I'm going to return this function. So return A plus B. So while returning that, what I have to do is this function will only return the value. To print that, we have to use something called document.writeline, document.writeln of add maybe 10 comma 20, like that. We have to pass the value. So this add is the function name. And this variable A is assigned to 10 and variable B is assigned to 20, and this will return the value. Now we can use document.writeln to print the value. So now we'll refresh. Oh, it's not working. Why? Function add document.writeln. So returns the value. Maybe I'll just delete this out. Me refresh. Yeah, so while passing the function value, no need to declare var here. In previous case, I have used like this var, so it is no need to use var there. So it will, you can simply pass A comma B, like that. So A is assigned to 10 and B is assigned to 20, and it returns the value. And using the document.writeln, it help us to call the function and assign the value and print the value. So this is how we can create functions in JavaScript. So functions can be created with help of function followed by function name, then internal logic. There are two types of function: function with return type and function without return type. In function with return type, we have to use something called return keyword, and this return keyword only returns the value. To print that, we have to use document.writeln. So any doubt, guys? So we have used about functions, and so we have seen like some half the part of JavaScript, because JavaScript is very easy to learn, and also like very very easy to validate. But it is of old style. Now people, they are going for jQuery and AngularJS. So we can learn this jQuery and AngularJS when we go for Spring framework or in J2W, we'll learn. And this basic, we'll use some basic JavaScript in J2W. Then I will show you why we are going to move from JavaScript to jQuery. Then when we learn about Spring concept, we'll see why we are going to move from jQuery to AngularJS like that. Okay, so any doubt, guys? Okay, so we'll go for the next thing, like internal event handling. So this internal event handling is nothing but event handling. So event handling is nothing but event is nothing but occurrence of something. So it is occurrence of something. For example, like clicking a button is one event. And for example, moving your mouse pointer is one event. Then pressing the button is one event. Like that, there are plenty of events are there. And this help us to validate our data, maybe. And we will use some of the internal event handling, like we'll use onClick. We'll use something called onClick, then onMouse, over. Then we'll use something called onMouse, out. Like that, or on key press or on key up, like that we will use some of the internal event handling functions. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a form in JavaScript, and using that form, what I'm going to do is I'm going to validate the form with the help of this internal event handling. So let me delete all the codes in which I have written, and also this one out. So what I will do is I will just create a form, and I will assign this form as check password, like that. Or I can simply use form name as form one, like that. And then I can use some method get or post maybe. Then I will close this form. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the name from the user, for example, name, input type equal to text is for getting the name, and I can assign some name for this name. I can put as N1 for the name. Then I can close with help of BR kind of thing. Then I can put a password. Password, input type equal to password, name equal to, I can put name equal to P1, can close this, then I can use BR for the next line. Then I will use confirm password. So I can use input type equal to password again. Name equal to P2. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to validate this with the help of the onClick. For example, like if I submit, so using the button input type equal to submit, when I click on the submit button, so I'm going to create an event called onClick. So this onClick is an event. Whenever this form is submitted, it will call this event. And whenever this onClick event is called, it will call the function. Maybe I can call as check function. Okay, so I have created an onClick event. Whenever this onClick event is called, this check function will be called. So I will create that function here inside JavaScript. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to check the purpose of this check function is to check whether the password the user entered and the confirm password the user entered is matches or not. So I'm going to do that actually. So for that, I'm going to create a variable called P1 for the password one. So what I can do is I can just type window. The format is window dot the name of the form I have to give, form one dot the value of the name for that particular field in which I want to retrieve. We have to give, for example, I want to retrieve P1 from this form. So the name is P1. So I can simply put P1 dot value. So this will retrieve, this will check for the form name, form one. So form one is there. And in this form one, it will check for P1. So P1 is also there. And whatever you enters in this input type equal to password, it is assigned to this P1. Then I will create another thing called P2. So the logic is window dot form one, the name of the form. So instead of P1, I need to get P2 dot value. Now we have to check whether this P1 and P2 are same. So now what I will do is I will put if P1 dot equals P2, because I'm using string. So I should not use like P1 equal to P2 like that. So since this is the string, we have to use P1 dot equals P2. Maybe we will just check whether it's working or not. So we have to use alert, and this will tell us like password matches, else password doesn't match. So we'll save this. We'll refresh. Yeah, we'll get the form now. So I'll just give some value password. So I'm going to give password as ABC123 for the first one. And for the second one, I will give XYZ123. So if I click on submit, oh, there is some bug. It is not printing the value. Maybe if there is any bug in the code, you can go for there is an option like you can go for option, and there is something called more tools, and you can click on developer tools. Just check. So I will give ABC in password one and XYZ in password two or confirm password. So there is, it shows some error into it. So you can see here in console, whenever there is an error, you can see here. So immediately it goes. Maybe we'll just check with this. Instead of equals, we'll just check with P1 equal to P2 like that. We'll just check with the code. So I will give ABC, then XYZ. Yeah. So I think like in JavaScript, it's not like P1 dot equals P2 is not supported, and we should use P1 equal to P2 like that. So it shows like password doesn't match. Suppose if I give some other value, like suppose if I give password as ABC and confirm password as also ABC, it will tell you like password matches. Okay. So this validation is called as on click validation, because I have given I have assigned this event to the button called submit, and there are so many events are also there. For example, instead of on click, I can use something called on mouse over. So in on mouse over, what it will do is whenever I place the mouse pointer over the submit button, it will perform the validation. For example, I will give ABC here, and the password is again ABC. Now I'm going to move the mouse over the submit. Now the mouse over event will call, and it will perform the validation. So now I place the mouse, then you see the password matches like that. Similarly, if I place the mouse again, you'll get like that. So this is called as on mouse event. On mouse event occurs when there is like when you place the mouse pointer over some controls, it will call this kind of event. So similarly, on mouse out is also there. You can try it with you can try yourself, and you can do that. There are plenty of events are available. So in on click, on mouse over is there, then on mouse out is there, then on click is there, then on double click is there, then on load is there. Whenever the form is loaded, it will we can use something called this on load. For example, I can create a function, say load like that. For example, this load I will create. Function load like that. Assume this whenever the body is loaded or whenever the page is loaded, it should display like welcome to website like that. Welcome to website like that. So that we can do with the help of this on load. Whenever the page is loaded, we can call this load function, and this load function will display welcome to website like that. So I'm going to refresh this. Oh, I need to close this one. No, it's not working. Maybe I will just go to more tools, then developer tools. There is no error message here. On load equal to load. Sorry. We have to put on load in body, not in form. So now it will work. So now whenever the page is refreshed, you'll see welcome to website, then followed by this page. So if I want to get some message through we can have like JavaScript compiler with in the browser itself. To go to that, we can use in Google Chrome, we have to select this option, then you have to select more tools, then you have to select developer tools like that. So developer tools, there is an option called console. Then in that console, we can, if there is any error, we can directly get the typo of the error like that. For example, like if I use something like for example if I use document dot, instead of write ln, if I use write e, the browser itself, it will show like it has the code like that. So you see like uncaught type error, document dot writely is not a function like that. It will show you in which line you will have the error like that. So in JavaScript we can debug the JavaScript in the browser itself, and there is an option called console. And so we'll just delete this, and if you use println, it won't show any error. See, it won't show any error, and it prints the error line like that. So this is just like a simple validation, and there are so many validations are also there. You have to explore that, and also I will post it in my forum. Maybe you can check for your references. And since we have limited number of time, because we need to proceed with J2W, the basics of JavaScript only we needed, and this basic will be enough for you. And then we'll go for like advanced thing when we see about jQuery and AngularJS. So we have seen about validation, and next we will see about regular expression. This regular expression plays a major role in a olden days of web application. For example, if you want to validate whether the user enters the correct data or not, the easiest way is we can go for regular expression. So before going for regular expression, now the expression, like we have to create an expression like this. We have to use this thing. Then you have to use the square bracket. If if you want to make sure that user want to enter only the alphabets, we have to use something called A2, small A2 Z, then capital A2, capital Z, like that. So this is the regular expression that satisfies only the characters like that. If the user wants to enter only the number, you have to use 0 to 9 like that. If the user wants to, if the user is allowed to enter the alphanumeric, like it can have the alphabets as well as the numbers, they can use A to Z or small A to Z. You can put it in any order. Maybe you can put small A to Z, then capital A to Z like that. Then followed by 0 to 9 or any format you can put. So this is one sample example for regular expression. And you have to put a plus. And you have to put a plus after every regular expression so that this plus is used for like more one or more occurrences. Like for example, if you put plus, it means like it can have a character like that. It can have one or more occurrences. The plus represents one or more occurrences. Similarly, 0 to 9, it represents that it can have like one or more occurrences. Like for example, we can use this in a telephone number, like and then if we similarly here also, this plus also indicates it can have one or more occurrences like that. So let me start with a regular expression. So I'm going to get the I will just delete the previous one and write a new code. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask the user to enter some characters. So using the regular expression, what we can do is you can check whether the user enters the character or number. If the number is entered, the regular expression will identify that and it will show you that there is the number included in your input, and please avoid like that. So again, I will use form for that. Form and name I can give is like form one, and then method equal to post, then slash form. Then I will get the maybe name from the user. Name, input type equal to text, name equal to name like that. Then we'll close this. Then br, age. So age, again I will perform validation because the age must be number. So input type equal to text, name equal to age, then br like that. So first we'll perform some validation for name and age, then we'll go for some other thing. So input type equal to submit, like that. So what I'm going to do is, once you enter the name, when you go for the age, the validation is going to start for this name. For example, when I make the mouse pointer over this age input, so I'm going to perform a validation. For that, the event handling method is like on focus. So whenever the mouse is focused in age, it will perform a check on name like that. So I'm going to create a function for this check on name. So function followed by check on name. Function check on name. Now I'm going to get the name from the form. So we can do with the help of form name. So I can retrieve it by var name equal to window dot the name of the form, form one dot the name of this aim control is again name dot value. Now what I will do is I will create a regular expression name for that. So to create a regular expression name, what the format is this one. So we have to put a slash, then this thing, then we have to give something like for the name it should be like it can have small a to z or capital A to z like that, then followed by plus, then followed by a dollar symbol. Dollar indicates that the regular expression ends like that. So this is the regular expression for validating whether the given data has only the characters like that. Now we can check, like, if name dot match or name, we have to check whether the given data is actually matched with regular expression. So alert, name is matched or name is valid, like that you can put. Else, alert, invalid date, invalid name, like that. Else, let me just check, refresh. So I will type the name. When I perform the on focus, it should work, but there is some error. Maybe we'll just go and check with that. More tools and developer tools. Yeah, there is invalid regular expression missing slash. I think we have to type this one. Yeah, we'll just check, then I'll just refresh, then I can give yeah. So when I place the mouse pointer on age, it is telling like name is valid. So yeah. Stop it. Okay. So when I place the mouse pointer on age, it will do validation for that. So this kind of validation is said to be an on focus validation. And this on focus validation can be used whenever, for example, after typing the name, when you place the mouse pointer on the age, it will perform that. And the next kind of validation we can do is we can use something called on key up. So on key up also can be used. So this on key up is nothing but when you type something, the event will be on key press. When you release or when you stop typing, it will just check the name like that. We'll just check. For example, I'm going to type, so I'm going to type some name. When I place a mouse pointer, it directly uses, like, we should not use this one. So when I type A and releases my key, it's telling like name is valid, like that. So this kind of event can be like used, but what the real programmer will do is like they will create this kind of thing on submit. Like here they will use like on click. When there is an on click, it will check all the functions, like it will check everything here. So whenever the submit button is clicked, it will check for this thing, and it will give that name is valid and invalid, like that, and it will make you to enter that again, maybe like window dot form1 dot name dot focus. Let's just check whether it's working or not. So we'll type age 32. We'll just type some 1, 2, 3 like that. Yeah. So it uses like whenever the form is submitted, it calls this. It is just telling that the name is invalid. And where is the focus is not okay. I will just check with this focus. Just check. So this is like a validation. Similarly, we can perform a validation on age also. The same code I can do. So for age, first let me get the age from the form, like window dot form one dot age dot value. Then where or age, that is the regular expression for ages. So slash, then this one, then we can put 0 to 9. And also you can apply the occurrences, like we can have the minimum value of maybe we can have a minimum value of 9 and the maximum value of 99 we can set. And we can put a dollar slash like that. So we can also set like this. So 0 to 9, the minimum value is 1 and the maximum value is 2. Or we have to do like this. The minimum length is 1. Maybe the age is from 0 to 9. And the maximum length of this age is 2. Maybe from 99 like that. Or if you want to put a, if you want to put 100, maybe you have to put 1, 3 like that. So it can have like, so this is added. Now we have to check if age dot match our age. If age dot match our age, alert age matched like that, or age is valid. So let me check with this code. So first I will give value. So if I give maybe some character. So, oh, it's telling invalid name. Okay, I think the space is taken. Okay. Let me give a space also. Give a rule then. Name is valid. Then why it's not showing age? Okay. Okay, for invalid age, we have not set any code. So we have to give code else alert invalid age. So let me refresh, give some value. So the name is valid. Age is, why it's not printing age, I don't know. Let me check with that. Maybe what is the problem? Maybe if I 0 to 9 plus, I'll just check. I think there is a problem in regular expression for age. Name is valid. Yeah. So if you give a minimum and maximum occurrences, we should not put plus. So the minimum occurrence is 1 and maximum occurrence length is 2. We should not put, when you put this kind of thing, you should not put the plus thing. So we'll just refresh and we'll just write a code. Then if I give an invalid thing, so the name is valid and the age is invalid like that. So this is about, all about validation in JavaScript. And using this validation, we can perform a validation for email ID, then we can validation, we can perform the validation for phone number, and we can do for many other steps. So far we have seen about some of the basic concepts of a JavaScript, and we have seen all the things about all the things which is displayed here, and this is enough for you to proceed with this is enough for you to proceed with J2EE course, and yeah, this is enough. But when you want to go for like higher frameworks like Spring framework or Spring Boot framework, like Java, we can use JavaScript, but there are some limited functionalities. We have to write plenty of codes for validation, like kind of thing. But we can use simply we can use jQuery or AngularJS because it has more functionality and no need to write many complex code. Like if you want to perform an email validation, you can just directly give an input type equal to email, and there is a set of functionalities we can use. So, but to learn about J2EE, we will just try to do with a basic olden way of JavaScript. Then we can go for something called jQuery and AngularJS. So that's all about today's thing. So we have studied the basics of JavaScript. Then we have seen the difference between Java and JavaScript. Then we will see how, then we have seen about how to create a variable in JavaScript. Then we have seen how to print something in JavaScript. Then we have seen how to create a pop-up message in JavaScript. Then how to get the content or how to get the value from the user with the help of prompt. Then we see how to create a function with return type and function without return type. Then we have seen some of the internal event handling like on click, then on mouse over, on mouse out, then on focus we have seen, then on load we have seen. Then we have seen something called validation, and we have seen normal validation like checking the password and confirm password. Then we have applied some regular expression kind of validation kind of thing. So this is all about some basics of JavaScript. This is enough to learn about J2EE. So if you have any doubt, maybe you can we can have some questions. Then else we'll wind up today's thing.